Welcome to the Photography News Show, where I bring to you the best and latest news in the photography industry. Coming up today, we have new Nikon lenses, a super cheap lens from TTArtisan, a drone that crashed into an erupting volcano, and much more. So, let's begin! Hey fellow photographers, it's Alessandro Carpentiero, travel photographer and tech nerd from Italy, and I want to welcome you to episode number 4 of the Photography News Show. This is a weekly series released every Monday, so make sure to subscribe not to miss any episode. With that being said, let's see what's new in the photography industry. Camera news. It looks like every week we keep getting a few more information on the Canon EOS R3. This time, it was Canon itself that updated the R3 website page with some interesting addition. We now know that it will use deep learning technology to improve autofocus performances and tracking, which will not only be helpful to capture humans or animals, but also cars and motorcycles, making it an awesome camera for motorsport photographers. Talking about autofocus, a couple of episodes ago, I mentioned that Canon published a patent for eye-controlled autofocus integrated into the viewfinder. And well, they have officially confirmed that it will be available on the R3, which is really exciting because it will most likely force other camera manufacturers to work on their own version of it if they don't want Canon to have an edge. Another interesting spec is that autofocus will work in light as low as -7 stops, which is really dark. And you'll get 8 stops of stabilization when using the camera together with the stabilized RF lens. Video-wise, it will shoot oversampled 4K in Canon Log 3, as well as RAW internal recording. And it will have wired LAN and 5 GHz Wi-Fi built-in to quickly transfer all your files. As you can see, it's gonna be a beast of a camera, and it will help the whole industry to strive for more. Lens news. This week, we have some interesting additions to the lens world. Nikon has launched its first Z-mount macro lenses, the 50mm f2.8 and the 105mm f2.8. The 50mm is designed for spontaneous street snapshots, food photography, or to explore the macro world, as it can reach a reproduction ratio of 1:1, while the 105mm is a higher quality lens as is part of the S lineup, so it includes nanocrystal and R-Neo coating to limit flare and ghosting. It also has a little and super convenient screen, which you can customize to display, for example, the lens aperture or the focus distance scale. This is a very macro-oriented lens, but it works great for portraits too. In fact, you can often use longer macro lenses, such as this one, to shoot super sharp portraits. And being a macro lens, you can get closer to your subject to capture tighter shots that you wouldn't normally be able to create with a standard portrait lens, as they have a longer minimum focus distance. The 50mm will come at $650, while the 105 at $1,000. Besides these two new lenses, Nikon has also announced 2 new compact lenses that will be launched later this year, the 28mm f2.8 and the 40mm f2. They both have a very compact design, which perfectly pairs with mirrorless cameras, making this a light and portable street photography kit. Talking about street photography, Chinese manufacturer TTArtisan has announced the 17mm f1.4 for APS-C and Micro Four Thirds cameras. It's a fully manual lens and it's very cheap, coming at $118. 17mm on a full-frame camera would definitely be too wide for street photography, but 17mm equals 27mm on an APS-C sensor and 35mm on a Micro Four Thirds sensor. So if you have any of these cameras and you're interested in practicing with some street photography or wide portraits without breaking the bank, this lens could be a good starting point. In general, I highly suggest you experiment with fixed focal length lenses, as they force you to think differently, move around to find the best composition, and at the end of the day, expand your creativity. The last arrival in the lens world is the Panasonic Lumix S50mm f1.8, made for full-frame cameras with an L mount, so for example Lumix, Leica, and Sigma, It weighs just 300 grams, is pretty compact, and it's dust, splash, and freeze resistant. All this makes it ideal to shoot pictures or videos while traveling light. As usual, you will find in the description all the links to the products I'm referring to. Software news. Software house DxO has released Nik Collection 4, which is the new version of its famous photo editing plugin. In case you don't know of it, it includes 8 programs that perfectly integrate with Adobe Lightroom and Photoshop, allowing you to do several things, including giving that extra punch to your images, removing noise, advanced black and white, and much more. I've personally been using it for many years, and I think it's a powerful tool to have in your creative toolkit. Price-wise, it comes at $149, but if you get it within June 30th, you'll pay just $100, while if you're upgrading, you'll pay only $60. The other software that has been launched this week is not about post-processing, but remote shooting. Nikon has in fact launched the NX Field Remote Shooting System, which allows you to connect multiple cameras to a router via wired or wireless LAN and remotely control all of them from your tablet. This allows you to capture the same moment of a scene from multiple points. If you think about it, this is extremely useful for sport and event photographers that place their cameras in specific spots where the action happens. In the past, this was done using radio triggers, but the problem with busy events is that you might have other photographers using the same channels, and that could cause your camera not to receive the signal. This new system solves this issue, and I'm sure we'll see it in use in the upcoming Tokyo Olympics. Pictures of the week. In this segment, I feature the most interesting pictures I've seen on the web. This week, I'm actually showing you a pretty unique video. Photographer and filmmaker Joey Holmes captured the eruption of the newest volcano in Iceland, Fagradalsfjall. What's so fascinating about this, except the Lord of the Rings look, is that he went really close, and I mean real close, until the drone crashed right into the exploding lava fountain. He sacrificed his drone, but well, the video got more than 1 million views in a week, so I guess it was worth it. And the drone he used is the DJI FPV, which is made for very fast action, as it can fly up to 87 miles per hour while capturing 4K video at 60 FPS, with a super wild field of view of 150 degrees. The drone comes at $739, while the combo, which includes the goggles and the remote, comes at $1,300. Weird news. The imaging world can be at times weird. This week, we have the canopy, which is a hand-free umbrella that allows you to protect yourself from the weather while keeping your hands free. It surely can be useful for certain applications, but the company says it's also awesome for photographers. But well, how can you bring your gear around if you're already wearing the canopy as a backpack? Rumors. This week, we have some rumors coming directly from Japan, from the website Asobinet, and there are some interesting lenses on the way. The first is the Olympus 8-25mm f4 Pro, which will be announced on June 9th. It's a Micro Four Thirds lens, so it's an equivalent of 16-50mm, making it a very versatile lens for landscape and travel photography. While the other rumor comes from some new patent that surfaced in Japan, which illustrates the lens scheme of 4 new full-frame lenses, which are the Sigma 135mm f1.8, the Tamron 16-70 f4, the Tamron 20-72 f4, and the Tamron 28-72 f4. It's not specified, but I would expect these lenses to come with different mounts to be used on all full-frame mirrorless cameras. So, let's wait and see. That's it for today. I really hope you've enjoyed this episode of the Photography News Show. Which news did you like the most? Just let me know in the comments below. And if you still haven't, make sure to enter the Photography Gear giveaway, which will run until June 27th. Just find the details in the description. If you've liked this video, please give it a big thumb up. And if you found it useful, I would appreciate it if you could share it with your photography friends. And if you need any help with your photography, I'm always here for you. Just DM me on Instagram at alessandro_carpentiero or send an email to support@alessandrocarpentiero.com. and I will be happy to help. So, thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one!